一步一脚印，生命电视陪您走过生命中的每一天。
接下来请收看菩提系列。
The Sangha is invited to go back to our breathing so that the collective energy of mindfulness can bring us together as an organism, flowing as a river with no more separation. Let the whole Sangha breathe as one body, chant as one body, listen as one body, transcending the frontiers of a delusive self.Liberating ourselves from the inferiority complex, the superiority complex, and the equality complex.
开始唱诵之前，请大众回到呼吸的关照上，让我们在集体的正念能量中融汇成一体，像河水一般流动，没有隔阂，让僧团呼吸如一体，念诵如一体。倾听如一体，超越自我的界限，从优越感、自卑感和等同感中释放。
To realize his true meaning. moving in the deep course of perfect understanding. Shed light on the five skandhas and found them equally empty. After this penetration, the overcame your being. Listen, Shariputra, form is emptiness, and emptiness is form. Form is not other than emptiness. Emptiness is not other than form. The same is true with feelings, perceptions, mental formations and consciousness. Listen, Shariputra, all dharmas are marked with emptiness. They are neither produced nor destroyed, neither defiled nor immaculate, neither increasing nor decreasing. Therefore, in emptiness there is neither form, nor feelings, nor perceptions, nor mental formations, nor consciousness, no eye, or ear, or nose, or tongue, nor body, or mind, no form, no sound, no smell, no taste, no touch, no object of mind, no realms of elements from my to my consciousness, no interdependent origins and no extinction of them, from ignorance to death and decay. No ill-being, no cause of ill-being, no end of ill-being, and no path. No understanding and no attainment, because there is no attainment. The Bodhisattva's grounded in perfect understanding find no obstacles for their minds. Having no obstacles, they overcome fear, liberating themselves forever from illusion, realizing perfect nirvana. All Buddhas in the past, present, and future, thanks to this perfect understanding, arrive at full and bright universal enlightenment. Therefore one should know that perfect understanding is the highest mantra, the unequal mantra, the destroyer of ill-being, the incorruptible truth, a mantra, a prajnaparamita. Therefore, we proclaim it. Gate, gate, para, gate, para, sangate, bodhisattva, gate, gate, para, gate, para, sangate, bodhisattva, gate, gate, para, gate, para, sangate,
practice free of obstruction. Take it.
refuge in the Buddha in myself. I aspire to help all people recognize their own awakened nature, realizing the mind of love. Taking refuge in the Dharma in myself, I aspire to help all people fully master the ways of practice and walk together on the path of liberation. Taking refuge in the Sangha in myself, I aspire to help all people build fruitful communities, to embrace all beings and support their transformation.
Good morning, dear friends. I welcome to the Day of Mindfulness. Every time we hear the bell, we stop thinking, talking. We go back to our in-breath, out-breath, and enjoy breathing in and out three times.
各位朋友，早安，欢迎到今天的一日禅或者是正念日。那在整个过程当中，我们一听到钟声，一听到磬声的时候呢，我们就放下手边的事，也不讲话，也不再想什么，就回到自己的呼吸上，吸气呼气三次，让我们完全的回到当下。
And during the time of breathing, we allowed our body to release the tension.
当我们这样子呼吸的时候呢，可以容许我们把身上所有的紧张就释放出来。
Fully establish ourselves in the here and the now, and release the past and the future.
让自己完全的安住在当下，把所有对未来的想法也统统放掉。
The practice of sitting relaxingly like this and breathing in and out can bring a lot of pleasure, relaxation.
就只是很安静的安住在当下，安住在自己的呼吸之上，这可以让我们变得很放松，我们可以享受那个安乐。
We do not have something to do. We do not have somewhere to go. We just enjoy ourselves in the here and the now.
在这样的时刻呢，我们没有要去做什么也没有要再去什么地方，就只是在当下很安住。
And peace and happiness is possible right away.
这样子平静和安乐马上就可以产生。
Thank you. When I was ordained as a novice at the age of 16, my teacher gave me a little book to learn by heart. There were only 50 little poems called Ke Gata to memorize in order to practice.
我十六岁出家做沙弥的时候，我的老师给我一本小书，里面有50个偈颂，让我在日常生活当中来修，就是毗尼日用。
And the first poem is for us novice to use to do the first thing we do.When we wake up in the morning.
那这五十个偈颂是要背下来的。那第一个就是关于早上起床的时候要怎么样关照。
It goes like this, waking up this morning, I smile.
他是这样说的，早上起来呢，我张开眼睛，我微笑。
There are 24 hours.Brand new hours for me to live.
我眼前有24小时全新的一天。
I vow to live these 24 hours deeply, entirely.
我发愿要在24小时中，我完全的活在当下。
And I make the vow to look at people around me with the eyes of compassion.
我发愿要以慈悲的眼光来看待所有的众生。
So the first thing you do is to breathe in and read the first line of the poem. Waking up this morning, I smile.
所以起床的第一件事情呢，就是想到这个偈颂，念这个偈颂，呼吸微笑。
You can stay in your bed.And breathe in and recite silently the first line.
你可以还是躺在床上，但是心里面就默念这个偈颂。
And then I breathe out and say the second line. I have 24 brand new hours to live.
然后再说第二句，就是我有24小时全新的一天可以活。
And then you breathe in again, and you read the third line, which I vow to live deeply and entirely these 24 hours.
然后前面就是一吸一呼，然后再吸气。第三句念的是，我发愿要全然这一天当中，我要全然的活在当下。
And when and after that, I breathe out and I say, I vow to look at people around me with the eyes of compassion.
然后再呼气，第四句，我们默念，我发愿要以慈悲的眼光看待所有的众生。
So you cannot practice unless you memorize the verse.
所以除非你把这些偈颂呢就记起来了，不然就没有办法这样子修。
And if you are a new practitioner, you might like to remind you of practicing that by putting something on the ceiling, on the mosquito net, so that when you wake up,You saw it, and you remember to practice breathing in and out with the gata.
所以，假如我们是初学者的话呢，还记不住，那可能要把这个偈颂写下来，贴在天花板上，或者贴在你的蚊帐上，这样子你躺着，就可以看到。
Although the verse is very simple, but it contains a lot of wisdom and happiness.
虽然这个偈颂听起来很简单，但是它里面包含了很多的智慧，也有很多的快乐在里面。
Waking up this morning, I smile because I know that 24 brand new hours are there before me to live. This is a good news.
醒来的时候为什么微笑呢？因为我知道我有24小时全新的一天可以活，这是个好消息。
The day is in front of you like a white sheet of paper. You would like to make good use of the day, like you want to write something beautiful on the sheet of paper.
这全新的一天呢，就好像一张白纸一样，那你可以写很多美丽的事情、美丽的语言、美丽的诗句在上面。
And 24 hours is a gift.And I vow not to waste that kind of gift. I want to treasure that gift, to live in such a way that make a joy, love, happiness possible.
这全新的一天呢，是一个很宝贵，是一个很珍贵的礼物。那我发愿，我要善用它，我不要浪费掉它。我可以在这一天让很多的喜悦快乐现起。
And especially you remind yourself that you should use the eyes of the Buddha, the eyes of compassion, in order to look at people that will make you happy and that will make them happy also.
尤其是第四句，就是我发愿要以佛的眼光，就是慈悲的眼光来看待众生，那这会带给我们自己快乐，也会带给别人快乐。
And then after practicing the gatha, you can get up, and you are searching for your slippers. And during the time you search for your slippers, there is another gatha for you to practice.
然后你就正念的起床之后呢，你脚就伸下来，你要找拖鞋了。那这个时候有另外一个寄送可以用。
I was very impressed by the second gatha because it expressed a lot of compassion.
我当时觉得对这个第二个寄送印象很深刻，因为这个寄送里面充满了慈悲。
It goes like this: from the very early morning to the end of the day, every living being has to take care of himself or herself.
那这个寄送是，应该是从朝明旦直至暮哈啊，然后所有众生自回护，是不是
？And if by chance I step on one of you, I'm sorry. I wish that you will be reborn right away to the pure land of the Buddha.
那接下来的意思就是说，假如我不小心，就是地上的众生，假如我不小心踩到你们，踩死你们的话，希望你们可以往生到极乐净土去。
You are a monk. You eat vegetarian. You try not to kill living beings. But it may be possible that while walking, you crush one or two of them under your slippers.
那我们是出家人，或者是佛法的修行人。那我们吃素，我们不杀生，但是走路的时候还是有可能踩到小昆虫之类，伤害到他们。
And that is mindfulness, that is awareness, and you have to apologize first.
所以，因为我们有正念的修行呢，我们知道一旦我们做不小心做了这样的事，我们要道歉。
You say that if it happens that I crush one or two of you under my feet, I'm sorry, and I pray that you will be reborn right away into the land of Amitabha Buddha.
所以我们就道歉说啊，如果我不小心踩到你们，伤害你们的性命，那希望你们马上此刻就可以往生到阿弥陀佛的净土去。
I was very impressed with the gatha.Because I think that the Buddhist path is a very beautiful path, full of joy, full of compassion, full of awakening.
所以我当时学习这些寄送的时候，我很欢喜，印象很深刻，知道说这里面是充满了慈悲，充满了喜悦的。
And then you have a gatha for you to use when you brush your teeth.
然后也有寄送是怎么刷牙。
You breathe you brush your teeth in such a way that make relaxation, happiness, joy, freedom possible during the time of brushing. You don't try to do it quickly in order to finish with it.
那刷牙的时候呢，也有正念来提醒我们放松，提醒我们喜悦，提醒我们正念，我们就不会急着要快快刷完。
There is a gata for you to use when you pour the water in order to wash your face. At my time, when I was novice, there was no running water in the temple. There is no electricity.
那接下来还有几种是怎么舀水来洗脸的？那在我那个时代呢，也没有自来水，也没有电力。
And when I button my robe, my mind is focused on the act. And there is another poem for you to breathe in and out while buttoning your robe.
穿衣服的时候，穿长衫的时候也是一样。当我在扣扣子的时候，也有一个偈颂可以用，来提醒自己用正念的呼吸来做这些动作。
Before you eat, or when you wash your bowl, there is also a gata for you to use.
那当我们在洗钵、在洗碗的时候，也有偈颂可以提醒我们用正念来做这些动作。
And you can make use of the 50 poems in your daily life in order to live mindfully, peacefully, happily.
所以这个有50个偈颂可以在日常生活当中用，帮助我们活得很有正念，很平静，很快乐。
I believe that in the Chinese Buddhist tradition, the novices have also a book like that to memorize when they become a novice.
我相信在汉传，在中国的传统里面也有这样的一本书，我们叫做《毗尼日用》，也有这样的一本书可以帮助我们在日常生活当中修习正念。
When I grew up as a young monk, I wrote a few more gathas for my use.
那在我自己出家的生涯当中，我还很年轻的时候，那我自己多写了几个偈颂来用。
And one of the gathas I wrote is about to ride a bicycle.
那其中一个呢，偈颂我写的就是怎么样骑脚踏车。
And in my time, monks and nuns did not ride bicycle.Not to say using scooters.
那我们那个时候呢，出家人不骑脚踏车，那也不要说骑摩托车了。
So I wrote a gatha so that we can use while riding a bicycle.
所以我要写这个偈颂呢，就是让我们可以去骑脚踏车。
And I am one of the six first monks in Vietnam to ride on a bicycle.
我是越南一开始有六个人骑脚踏，开始出家人骑脚踏车，我是其中的一个。
I wrote a gatha for our use before you make a telephone call.
那我还写了一个偈颂，是关于怎么打电话、使用电话的。
Before you make a phone call.You touch the telephone and you breathe in and out two times.
那在我手去摸电话的时候呢，在拨电话之前，我先呼吸两次。
The first line is words can travel several hundreds of miles.
第一句是说语言可以传千里。
The second line, they can build up mutual understanding and friendship.
语言可以帮助建立互相的了解，互相的沟通。
And I wish that what I'm going to say will be beautiful like flowers.
我希望我的美字字句句说出来就好像一朵花一样美。
I wish that what I'm going to say will be beautiful like flowers.
我希望我说出来的话像花一样美。
And after you have breathing in and out two times and did that, you become calm. And then you can compose the number.
然后经过两次的正念的呼吸之后呢，我们安静下来，我们就可以去拨号码了。
So before making the phone call, you make the vow to use loving speech, right speech, recommended by the Buddha in the Noble Eightfold Path.
所以在我们打电话之前呢，借由这样的正念的关照，我们就会在讲电话的时候就能够用爱语去说话，爱语就是正语，就是佛陀八正道里面的正语。
If you are calm thanks to the breathing, relax thanks to the breathing, and if you have made the vow to use a loving speech, the quality of your conversation must be good.
所以因为你已经有正念的呼吸关照，然后你又发了这样的愿，你要用爱语来说话，所以你在真的讲话的时候，你那个讲话的品质会是很好的。
And if you hear the telephone bell ringing, you don't answer right away. You use the sound of the telephoneLike the mindfulness bell, you practice breathing in and out mindfully and release the tension in your body.
那在我们听到电话铃响的时候呢，那也可以练习正念的关照，就好像我们听到庆声一样，是一种正念的钟声。那我们也是不要急着去接电话，就先正念的呼吸几次，两次、三次。
The gathaThat I practice when I hear the bell has only two lines.
那原先那个寄送是我写的呢，只有两句。
The first line is I listen deeply. The second line is this wonderful sound brings me back to my true home.
对不起，这个是指我们古典传统的寄诵，它只有两句，它的意思就是请听，请听，这个钟声把我带回到我真正的家。
Listen, I listen means that I listen not only with my ears, but I invite my whole body, all the cells in my body to join me in listening to the bell.So that the sound of the bell can penetrate into every cell of my body and help them to relax.
当我们听这个钟声的时候，不是只用耳朵来听，是我用我的整个身心去听，让我身上的每一个细胞都被这个钟声穿透，然后可以放松安静下来。
The practice can be very deep.Because while you are listening to the bell, you can invite all your ancestors in you to join in and listening to the bell. Because we know that our ancestors are still alive in every cell of our body.
这样子的听电话声、听钟声的练习看起来简单，但是它可以是非常深刻的。因为我们知道我们所有的祖先，我们的先人其实就在我们身上的每一个细胞当中跟我们一起活着，所以当我们这样子聆听的时候，我们也邀请我们的所有的祖先一起来跟我们正念的聆听。
Because you are alive, that is why all your ancestors are still alive in you, because you are their continuation.
因为我们是活着，所以我们的祖先也是活着的，因为我们是他们的延续。
So if you allow your body to relax and receive the bell and become relaxed, and all our ancestors in us will be relaxed also.
所以当我们听到钟声，我们有正念的呼吸，我们可以放松全身，可以安详的话，所有我们的祖先都一起享受这份正念安详。
This wonderful sound brings me back to my true home, because my true home is not in the past. Mind to whom is not in the future. Mind to whom is in the here and the now, where life and all the wonders of life are available.
说正念，说钟声可以带我回到真正的家呢，是因为这个钟声让我回到现在。这个现在就不是未来，不是过去，生命只有在当下这一刻才是可能的，才存在的。当下这一刻，所有的生命的奇迹就在这里。
In fact, the practice of breathing in and out mindfully, and the practice of listening to the bell, they all have the capacity.The function to help us go home to the here and the now, our true home.
事实上，正念的呼吸和正念的聆听钟声，这样子的修行都能够把我们带回到当下，也就是带回到当下真正的我们的家。
Because when you breathe in mindfully, you bring your mind back to your body, and suddenly.You become, alive in the here and the now.
因为当我们正念的呼吸，把心带回到身体上来，我们会突然发现自己活过来了，活在当下。
It takes only 3 or 4 seconds for you to breathe in mindfully, and.By doing so, you release the past, you release the future, you release your projects, your worries, and you go home to the here and the now in order to be in touch with the wonders of life that are available in the here and the now.
在三四秒钟，只要三四秒钟，借由正念的呼吸，你把自己带回到当下。这一刻，你不去想未来，不去想过去，不去想你的计划、你的焦虑这些，那这就容许你完全的活在当下，去享受生命的美好。
And when we get in touch with the refreshing and nourishing and healing.In us and around us, our body and our mind begin to be nourished and to heal.
当我们借由这样子的练习回到当下，我们会发现生命当中很多美好的事情在我们里面，还有在周遭。那这些美好的元素可以帮助我们疗愈，帮助我们放松，转化自己的身心。
护生协会秉持佛陀无缘大慈同体大悲以及众生平等慈悲相待理念，慈悲置业于2002年成立了中华护生协会，以倡导救护一切众生。尤其时代环境变迁，放生一定要配合政府所宣导的保护生态环境以及物种生存条件等各方配套措施，在放生更要护命的宗旨下，护生协会这几年都采用筹建护生园区的方式来拯救生命，以安养物命的方式来推广，来救护生命。目前护生园区于宜兰共有4处园区，新北有1处园区，于云嘉南地区有10处，高平地区6处，金门设有1处， 护生协会在众生平等、慈悲相待的理念下所推广的会务有：一、不定期举办各类护生救生活动，以教化世人尊重生命、爱护生命；二、认养清寒学童的活动，筹集清寒子弟助学专款项目，以及提供海外僧伽医护经费，带国外僧众寻找护持功德主等行动；三、国内外急难救助以及因生未生胎儿的免费超度登记；四、协助佛教慈悲置业基金会2021年结下的防疫共僧包发放等。只要是护持众生、利益众生的善行，都是护生协会所努力的方向。
大家好，我是台大病院张尚顺医师。还没注 COVID-19 疫苗的时段，若是去感染到，较容易引发重症和死亡。提醒大家赶紧带时段去注疫苗。你会用的搜寻 COVID-19 防治预防通，查询上近会用的注射的地点，也用的按照疫苗的厂牌搜寻，根据查到的资讯协助时段注文注射。注射进程确认时段身体状况稳定，注射以后注意时段是不是有身体不爽快，卡数出现发烧超过48点钟、喘气困难、心跳伤紧、头壳晕、全身躯起疹毛等等，请赶紧去找医生，注 COVID-19 疫苗，守护时段身体健康。
及圣神之名，
阿们。
现在我们大家准备我们的心灵，好能虔诚地举行圣祭。
好，最近一个月，教会啊，为我们台中教区，我们也发动各种的祈祷，每天的弥撒。下午5点钟的一起念玫瑰经，每一个礼拜四的朝拜圣体等等啊，都是为这些亡者的灵魂的安息，为确诊者的痊愈，为先行工作的第一线的医护警消人员来为他们来祈祷除了祈祷之外，我们也回应天主的爱就是以具体的实践来关心这些需要特别陪伴的受苦的弟兄姐妹们所以我们也有物资的发放有一些不方便来亲自领物资的人我们的志工们也把物品送到他们家里面去那我们也有街友特别无家可归的人，我们也送上我们的口罩等等所有的一切就是为了我们都是弟兄姐妹的这份爱的信仰里面，我们也希望把天主的爱、把天主的同在跟他们分享透过我们宗教界的联合的祈祷使这个疫情早日弥平，让我们的社会能够早日回到 正常的生活，我们以爱彼此相伴啊，那我们就怀着这样的意向啊，我们继续来做啊这个祈祷。教宗放弃各意向，特别在五月协同圣母，我们展开马拉松的祈祷。仁慈的天父，我们感谢你赐给我们来自不同的族群、宗教和文化背景的台湾人民的各种恩惠，求你怜悯我们，并转变我们的心。求你在人心不安的日子里，垂怜我们众人。求你拯救那些因得到生存冠状病毒而去世人，并使所有遭受感染的病人早日康复。求你降福并保护那些未照顾被隔离的病患，所有医疗团队成员，保佑他们身心灵平安。我们也特别为世界国家而祈祷，尤其是执政者、政府官员和各个政党，求主赐给他们睿智、眼见、毅力、信心，在这关键的时刻都能虚心信靠上主，并能同心协力、团结一致，共度难关，使各国人民早日恢复平安快乐的生活。以上所求是靠我们的主基督，阿门。
天主降的牛总主降，佛光山住持心宝和尚，天主教善国喜基金会的大众，各位佛光人，各位观众，大家吉祥。新型肺炎疫情从开始到今天仍然在持续的蔓延传播中，现今我们全球人民因疫情快速的增加，使它造成生活上极度的不方便，另外呢，心灵在恐惧中受创更多的严重。在这种高度传染险峻环境当中，人心感到惶恐不安，当内心烦闷无助的时候，一定要忍耐，而并且能够控制好自己的情绪，要有坚定信心而心不退转。为此风雨过后总会呢拨云见日，看见希望的阳光来照耀我们大千世界。在此艰难困难的时刻，是需求忍耐生活上各种不便，我们更需要团结一心，具备勇气跟智慧，共同面对疫情，互相关怀，彼此呢劝勉鼓励，增进自己的信心和意志力，才能够远离颠倒梦想，永离忧伤，消灾免难。让我们共同来祈愿，祈求诸佛菩萨的加倍，让这个社会能够进化，主席这些疫情能够赶快过去，国家平安。现在我们来以佛光山心灵大师为疫情来求愿的观世音菩萨，我们大家一起合掌来祈愿。
慈悲伟大的观世音菩萨，这一次新型肺炎疫情，许多人受到委屈、苦难和惊吓，祈求您的慈悲加倍，让我们具备勇气和智慧，面对疫情能够处变不惊， 面对疾病能够冷静宽心。慈悲伟大的观世音菩萨，有些地方封城了，有些活动暂停了，现在我们更需要发挥您救苦救难的精神，互助关怀，避免惊慌失措，彼此鼓励，增加信心无畏。虽然一时的不便，但我们可以拿静心正念，自我潜修。慈悲伟大的观世音菩萨，此时此刻我们更需要团结一心，相信医疗人员政府部门会尽快的解除危机。感谢医护工作人员正在努力来医治病患。世界上无论在怎么样的困难，只要以慈悲智慧来面对，我们总是要心三好，大家重视环保卫生，就能够转恶为安。慈悲伟大的观世音菩萨，此时此刻我们虔诚称念您的名号，我们要学习您的慈悲与智慧，转化外在的烦恼境界。我们要远离颠倒梦想，我们要远离分别猜测，我们要远离执着缠丝。慈悲伟大的观世音菩萨，祈求你让生病的人尽快的痊愈，赶快给他恢复健康，不幸往生者蒙福皆缘，能够安心到极乐世界，让社会净化，远离疫情，让普罗大众平安吉祥。南无观世音菩萨，祈求您接受我铸成的祈愿。观世音菩萨，请求您接受我铸成的祈愿。
最近疫情爆发，我们看到的几乎全是负面新闻，政客的互相谩骂以及名嘴越来越激烈的言辞，当然会造成一般老百姓的焦虑和不安，让他们的心情不好，对国家不是一件好事。其实我们不妨想一想，我们的社会仍然在持续的运作，所以我们应该有一种感谢的心情，我们应该感谢所有的医护人员，他们是在最危险的情况之下工作的，我们也应该感谢全国那些全副武装的士兵以及维持交通的工作人员。我们应该在这个时候更加关心别人，要知道疫情对很多人的身体是有负面影响的，如果你知道有些亲友因为疫情而必须放无薪假，你应该和他通话，或许你不能对他有实质上的帮助，至少可以使他的心情好一点。我们应该在这个时候使大家冷静一点，关心很多其他的事情。最重要的是，我们的社会最需要的是两句话，谢谢你和你好吗。
各位亲爱的朋友，大家吉祥，大家好，我是国际博览会中华总会的小李。新冠肺炎病毒仍然在全世界大多数地区蔓延，而我们的台湾也仍然处在高度警戒之下。我们希望继续为台湾这块我们重要的土地奉献一个心力。不过最近多了很多闭门静坐和醒思的机会，我相信各位都有同感。就是这次疫情之所以如此严峻，主要还是源自于大自然界对人类过去一些不当的行为所造成的反扑，像是这么多年以来的环境污染，像是 人类持续的对动物的残杀，甚至于由于人性的偏颇而造成社会上人心不古，人与人之间相互的猜忌、相互的排挤、相互的争斗，这些都是我们引以为忧的事。今年年初，幸运大师颁布了他的集句，是八个大字，就是花开四季，耕耘心田。或许这正是一个绝佳的机会，让我们一起来进行一次净化人心的工作。就让我们用心来倾听这些智者的语言，也让我们用心来思考一下，我们应该如何规划一个更为幸福和安宁的场域，作为未来人类安身立命的环境。最后，我祝福各位平安、健康、吉祥、圆满。
用慈悲智慧，让我们步步关怀，希望疫情早日远离。
活出爱，永远向好。祝福大家用慈悲与智慧面对疫情。
活出爱，永远向好。
一起用祷告来度过这次的难关。
我加油。
台湾之旅，爬山
的台湾，我出海，台湾加油，耶！
护持功德殊胜行，无边胜福皆回向，普愿沉溺诸众生，速往无量光佛刹，十方三世一切佛，一切菩萨摩诃萨，摩诃般若波罗蜜。